Okay, first question for you. What would you do in the first 90 days if elected?
If I'm fortunate enough to be elected to sit on the city council in Ogden City, in the first 90 days, I think it's of critical importance to do two things. First of all, I think it's important that the new city council and a new mayor convene to create a vision for Ogden City. And then underneath that vision, that we all work together to set goals to move toward accomplishing to bring that vision to life. The other thing that I think would be very important in my first 90 days is to continue and stay engaged with the voters of Ogden City, and particularly District 4, but not exclusively, period. I think I'm talking to Siri. Sorry. So I've learned a lot during the campaign season. I've knocked on about 2,700 doors and spoken to numerous people, both on their front porches and in their offices and their homes across District 4. And I've learned a lot. And I think there's a lot more to be learned. And engagement with the voters of Ogden City will be very, very important to continue.
Thank you. What is more important? Acting in response to the will of the people, or acting in a way that city officials believe is best course of action?
This is a really great question that asks one to balance the two things. What I've come to understand as I've taken on this role and the possible responsibility of sitting on city council is this. It is incumbent upon me to know what I'm comfortable with. I need to be learning and understanding and fully understand all the issues that come before us as a city council. And I need to be listening to the wishes and hopes for the city from the electorate. It's going to be a combination of input from the expertise that is the city and how it runs and how things work, blending with the wishes of the community, and then making a well-informed decision that I'm comfortable with. I'm going to do my homework and studies so that I know in my heart that the decision that I've made is the right one, and I can stand to defend it with either the city if I vote against their wishes, and or with the voters if I don't follow through and do what's popular amongst the electorate.
Thank you. What is your greatest weakness and what is your greatest strength, and how can you apply that to your campaign?
Thanks for that too. I think my greatest strength is kind of multifold. I'm a hard worker, and I really want to understand everything fully. So I engage fully in the understanding, as I spoke about in the last question. I think another strength is my ability to work with others. In my professional background, I worked with numerous groups within an organization to bring everything to the fore in one culminating event. And it took a lot of collaborative effort, good communication, and action. My greatest weakness is probably the same as my greatest strength. I probably apply a little bit more of myself to my work than I should. And I struggle to create that boundary around where work stops and where my life should begin and continue.
Thank you. What are the most significant differences between you and the candidate you're running against?
The significant difference, as I understand it, is my background. I have spent 7.5 years on Ogden City's Planning Commission. I have great insight into the plans that have been laid into place to move Ogden through this period of extraordinary change and growth so that we hold on to the culture and the historic portions of Ogden while welcoming others to Ogden and improving the life of everybody that lives here. I also really, as I mentioned in the previous question, pride myself in my ability to work and collaborate with others. And I see that as a difference between myself and my opponent as well. I've got the experience in that area. Additionally, my business background. I spent 32 years building a successful successful small business, and I can bring that understanding of the world to City Council, most specifically as I interact with small businesses in the community and work on the budget.
Thank you. Communities across the state are concerned about growth and condensed housing in their communities. Within the last few years, numerous apartment complexes have been built. How will you address the concern of the city housing crisis?
Yeah, that's a great question too. And with growth comes concerns like this, and they're valid. The apartment complexes in specific have been one of the number one things on front porches as I've knocked on doors. What's with all these apartment buildings? I want to distinguish the difference between Ogden City and South Ogden. However, a lot of folks don't realize that the apartment buildings being built near Costco is South Ogden. The apartments being built on Country Hills Drive west of Harrison Boulevard that are crowding the curb are also South Ogden. Now, Ogden admittedly has placed some apartment buildings in commercial zones that are too close to the street. In other words, not enough setback. And my understanding of the reason and my explanation for the reason for that is this. Ogden didn't have a lot going on for a good period of time. And then Utah became the fastest growing state in the union, and with it, Ogden as well, as developers looked to create projects here. It was discovered in the commercial zones that setback requirements allowed developers to build bigger apartment buildings on smaller pieces of land because of the lack of setback requirements. I would like to give the city credit for having recognized that relatively quickly, and we have seen the ordinance requiring setback, amenities, and common areas redefined in our commercial zones so that apartment buildings going forward will be more attractive in Ogden. Additionally, Ogden is, and Utah are very quickly growing right now, and we're behind about 3,500 housing units in the state. That creates a demand for housing in some way, shape, or form. People want to live in Ogden. There's not a lot of opportunity for single-family housing at this point in time, so apartment buildings have gone up to accommodate the demand amongst folks who would like to live in Ogden. There will be an opportunity to create more single-family housing in Ogden proper, and affordable single-family housing also. I'll point to the development near St. Joseph's Church that will provide single-family housing. On Quincy, just to the north of 24th Street, there will be single-family housing at Capitol Square, and we expect single-family housing to be built on small lots on the old Grandview School site and on the old Kingston LDS Church site. So there's opportunity for Ogden to provide affordable housing, better-looking apartment buildings, and fill the need for housing as the demand grows in Ogden City.
Thank you. Just a small follow-up. A lot of this was answered, but if you can provide any more clarification. If elected, how would you address the citizens' concerns and address the city's the needs of the city? So if the citizens approaching you, which you likely will have, a good chunk of them that come into you concerned about this specific topic, how will you address those concerns with them?
Yeah, I think that some of this is listening and understanding what the concerns of the individuals within the community are. And then I think that some of it, too, is engagement and providing some insight and understanding to the whys and hows within the city itself. I think there's a lot of positive that will come from population growth in dense neighborhoods that will benefit the city. Most specifically, population creates economy. So as money is spent, taxes are collected, and it bolsters our city budget. When there's density, like there will be at Capitol Square at 25th and Monroe to Quincy to 24th, it creates walkable neighborhoods that will support commerce and service and dining and has access to public transportation, which will lessen the number of cars on the road and help reduce our air pollution in the wintertime especially. But overall, we need to be conscious of our air quality in Ogden. So population density is not a bad thing. Growth of population can also be a benefit to our budget.
Thank you. We are currently in the age of technology and social media. Ogden City Council has made efforts to reach out and connect with community members. With most politics, it's hard to get them, the community, to engage in topics until it negatively impacts them. If elected, what would you do to change your connection with your community?
Yeah, I think it's amazing to me. If there's one thing that has been apparent, it's the lack of engagement. And I don't think it's because there is an interest. I think I've come to understand that our communication and the way that we receive information has become so fragmented in today's modern age. And our newspapers used to land on our porches, be widely consumed with very significant subscription rates, and that was the news and information and one place we went to it to get it. Today, our newspapers struggle. Social media delivers information in a very splintered fashion across numerous platforms. You might find 10 or 20 or more Facebook platforms that are specifically concerned with Ogden, and they all bring their own subject matter of interest and their own perspectives to conveying information and inviting participation. And I don't think that serves well in engaging the community as a whole. It will be a challenge, and I think that what I've come to believe is that the best way to do this is to create an environment where I am available to people to listen and talk about Ogden. That's where I've learned the most about what's on the minds of Ogdenites, and I believe it's going to be the place where I can share what's going on with Ogden and then get feedback from the voters and residents of District 4.
Thank you. So would like you to just briefly go over what you've been assigned to with committee assignments, what have you worked for the city, and then tell us what you've done outside of those assignments to connect with your community.
Yeah, this is really cool. I landed in Ogden in 2014 as I married my wife, Kim, and I had spent 32 years in another state. Being retired when I arrived here just provided all kinds of opportunity for me to become engaged and involved. And one of the first ones was Weber Pathways, which is a nonprofit dedicated to creating non-motorized travel in Weber County. And my years on that organization's board taught me a great deal, introduced me to wonderful people in the community, and that led to my volunteerism at the Goal Foundation. They had many, many opportunities to engage in supporting activities and events in Ogden, including the marathon, for which I have continued to stay engaged, both with the expo out at Weber State University prior to the marathon day itself, and I'm a team lead for the production of the marathon each spring. And I've tremendously enjoyed that experience. I've had the opportunity to work at Snow Basin Resort in a number of different capacities and met wonderful people there. I served as an adjunct instructor at Weber State University for 3 years in the School of Professional Sales. That was an outstanding experience. And then my 7.5 years on the Planning Commission at the city has exposed me to numerous persons in various positions at the city level, and I've learned a great deal about how Ogden operates, what its dreams are for the city and its residents, and it's been a tremendous growing experience for me overall to be involved in such a broad spectrum of opportunity within the city of Ogden, and I'm very grateful for that.
Thank you. What have you done to support your first responders in your community?
I think I've done several things, a couple of them just for my own learning. And that's recently sat with Chief Young in his office for about an hour, getting to know the challenges of his position and his department, and getting insight into what law enforcement is in Ogden City. And then I did ride along during a shift, second shift, with an officer in his patrol car. And I got to see firsthand what Ogden City's first responders are asked to deal with. And it was an amazing experience for me. I think the most significant thing that I did to support first responders in Ogden City was attend a truth and taxation hearing a number of years ago in the city council chamber here in Ogden. And it was clear to me, after doing some study, that Ogden City was losing trained officers, newly trained officers, to other municipalities that paid a higher wage after having invested in recruiting, training, and then placing them in a role for the city after a short period of time, losing them and all the expense that it invested in the front end. The request on the part of first responders was a raise. And to get a raise, we needed to raise taxes. And I spoke in favor of raising our property taxes in order to facilitate a competitive wage to retain our officers so that they can serve our city after we've invested in their training.
Thank you. Tell us about your past experiences with law enforcement, whether positive or negative.
All of my experiences with law enforcement have been positive. I haven't had any run-ins with the law, quote unquote, other than traffic violations. And those have always been very professionally handled on the part of officers, very much in the right with regard to what they were stopping me for, running a stoplight or a stop sign or speeding in certain circumstances, or in the case of, you know, a traffic accident. So I've always had positive experiences with police and with fire personnel, and I support them in the role that they do. It's a difficult job.
Thank you. Moving into representing your area that you're running for, an officer has been accused for alleged misconduct within your city. How would you respond to the situation?
Accusations are one thing, and truth and full understanding of what the circumstances are something else. And I would support a complete and thorough investigation into understanding what the facts of the circumstances are before levying any judgment on any individual that puts himself or herself in harm's way in their duty to provide protection for us.
Thank you. What would you do if an officer who represents Ogden City gets into a shooting? The initial video is controversial, and you have constituents that are demanding action from you. How would you respond to that?
I would respond by asking for patience. Things aren't always what they appear to be initially, and a more thorough examination is both what we would expect if we were standing in those shoes. We're innocent until proven guilty in a court of law. And officers deserve the same thing. They put themselves in harm's way, and a plea for patience and to trust the process is a very important thing.
Thank you. A significant concern of public safety is the decisions made by their elected officials when they do not understand how public safety operates. Would you be willing to attend a Citizens Police Academy?
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you. Will you commit to an ongoing engagement with your public servants to understand the work that they perform for you and meet with representatives of the employees?
Not only would I welcome it, I think it's my responsibility. This isn't show up on Tuesday for a scheduled meeting to be responsive and engaged in the business of city council. It's also a learning opportunity, and I'm not learning anything if I only take a seat in the city council chamber. I need to take a seat with police officers and other members of our community that are employed by the city to understand what their roles and concerns are. And that goes to the learning that I have set out to gain through engagement. And that's why I'm running for office. I wanted to learn and be engaged.
Thank you. Ogden City has failed to stay competitive in compensation and appropriate staffing levels with its employees, which made it Ogden a training agency for the public safety departments across the state. Salary is generally only addressed when the public safety departments enter into a crisis of loss of personnel and staffing concerns. As a council member, what are your plans to ensure your public safety personnel have the right resources, both pay and benefits included?
Yeah, this is something that comes from my business background. I employed numerous people. And their roles were important in my business operation, and I valued them as people that did their jobs. And to hire somebody and then lose them due to lack of competitive pay cost me as a business a lot of money. I invested in recruiting them, I invested in training them, I trusted them to do their work, and then I was able to let them do their work and tend to mine. The same would apply with our public servants. If we aren't staying in tune with what is necessary to be competitive in the workplace or the marketplace around our professional help, it costs us money in the long run to recruit and train and then employ for a short period of time individuals that go to another agency is a waste of our tax dollars. We would be better served to pay them well in a competitive salary after we get them recruited, hired, and trained.
Thank you. Do you have any specific plans or things you would like to do to accomplish that?
I think this really just take you up on the invitation to be present with those that serve, so I understand fully what the concerns are when in Ogden City when laid against other communities for comparison. We don't want to lose people to other communities. We want to employ the intellectual asset that is the experience of Ogden police officers in our community, not see them migrate somewhere else. So it's just be in touch and be smart about understanding what the issues are amongst our first responders.
Thank you. Well, I appreciate you meeting with us for this discussion and getting the answers from you. Would you like to give a closing statement? Just briefly describe your campaign, who you are, and what you would like to see and why you're the best candidate for the position.
Thank you very much. You know, when I contemplated and then made the decision to run for city council, I, one, wanted to have fun, and two, I understood I didn't need to be employed anymore, but I needed to be engaged and learning. And then finally, I want to give back to this community that's been so welcoming, supportive, and wonderful to live in. So I have had fun. This has been a wonderful opportunity to be engaged, and I've picked up a lot of learning, and I hope to continue to give to Ogden City as I have as a city planning manager and in my varying not a city planning manager, a city planning commissioner. There's your edit. A city planning commissioner and a volunteer across the spectrum of opportunities within Ogden City. I look forward to serving Ogden as a city councilor and specifically District 4. Thanks a lot for this opportunity today. I appreciate it.
Thanks.